Just watch this as we are waiting to experience the fire. The disciples were gathered in the upper room, and it's not an accident that here in AUP we are gathered here in the upper room. Amen. This afternoon it's all about God. We have to truly humble ourselves, and we are going to be deliberately intentional. We are going to be deliberate, intentional in seeking God. I want to just welcome each and every one of you in the sweet name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want to welcome you all in a very special way to this special place. It is called the spiritual ICU. I want all of you to know your spiritual health. Please watch your spiritual life. We are spiritually dead. We are spiritually dead. And there are many in the ICU that are literally dying. It is time to call the doctor. Session number one is entitled Prayer Surgery. Get ready because the surgeon is coming. Before that, let's invite the Spirit of God to be present. Session one is entitled as Prayer Surgery. I want to invite Miriam and Eunice to sing a special number as I call you and me to this very special place. Call the doctor. Welcome to the prayer surgery.
I'm water of life that you offered so good and so free. I'm thirsty, dear Lord, for your water and word, for to drink will refresh and bless me.
There is a desperate need for all of us to undergo a prayer surgery. If you have brought your Bibles, please come with me for our first prayer session, Ezekiel chapter 16. We are going to look at verse 4. Ezekiel, the 16th chapter, and verse 4. We are going to go through four simple steps as we enter into this first session of prayer called the prayer surgery. Prayer surgery. Let me begin by asking a question. People of God, just imagine your wife has been wheeled into the OT, the operation theater, the OB gynecologist, right? She goes there and then they come out with the good news that you have a baby. But for them to undergo the surgery is a big challenge. What is the first thing the gynecologist does right after your child is born? I know I'm talking to young people who are not married, but I still guess you have that knowledge. What is the first thing the gynecologist does? Slap them? No. That is, I'm happy some of you are not doctors, you know. What is the first thing they do? Look, let's look here. As for thy nativity, that is the day you and I are born, in the day you were born. Why are we gathered here? We are fasting, we are praying, we are seeking God. On the day we were born, thy navel was not cut. Do you want to know our real spiritual strength, spiritual state? Many of us still, after 30 years, 40 years, are still walking with our navel cord attached. This afternoon, the Spirit of God is going to cut our navel cord. Amen. The old life will be passed. The sinful life, whatever tied you to flesh, this old desire, old nature, carnal nature, flesh, sin. We cannot pray with sin in our hearts. The Bible says, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear. Before we have the prayer surgery, I want all of you to come to Jesus. No wonder Jesus said, you must be born again. Please allow Jesus to use his knife and scissor to cut your navel cord. And number two, welcome to the prayer surgery. Thou was not washed in water to supple you. When the child is born, the child is so cute, but it's full of dirt. Blood smeared all over. There's a lot of amniotic fluid because it has been floating in the mother's sac for almost 9 months. And the baby is cute, but very dirty and smelly. That's how you and I all gathered here. The prayer surgery helps you to allow Jesus to deal with your spiritual life, that you not only allow him to cut your old sinful way, number two, he's going to wash you with his blood right now. Amen. Number three, this is very amazing. Thou was not salted at all. Back in the Bible times, they didn't have antiseptic agent. When the child was born, when the navel was cut, the very first thing they did was they would take a handful of salt and rub them so that there will be no infection. Many of us have infection. Many of us carry the virus of sin. Why? We have not allowed the Holy Spirit to rub us. It's not only important that Jesus cuts your old life. It's not only important that Jesus washes you with his blood. It's important that Jesus will put the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will never come until you and I pray. Finally, nor swaddled at all. I would like to see the raising of hands. Those of you who were born with a three-piece suit. Anybody here? Absolutely not. We were all born naked. The prayer surgery blesses you and me to be clothed with the righteousness of Jesus. Let's have the opening prayer. Welcome to prayer surgery. The opening prayer is in the form of reading 12 verses from Psalm 51. I want to tell you, my friends, this is not a program. This is not an event. This is prayer. And I want all of us to be very honest with God. Let's all offer our opening prayer by reading silently, very silently, the passages, the three slides that will follow. Here, Lord, we offer our opening prayer. Everybody, focus on your passage. Prayer continued. Shall we all stand as we silently offer this prayer? This is the most important part of the prayer this afternoon. Everybody stand. We will take 2 minutes to offer this prayer that God will perform that surgery to remove sin in your life and my life. We shall all read together, beginning from verse 9. 1, 2, 3. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. The first opening prayer will be offered when we are on our knees. And this is going to be a personal prayer as you all kneel. All of you will confess our sins. The next 3 minutes will be a prayer, absolutely silent and reverent, confession of sins, before God fills us with the Holy Spirit. Please pray for the next 3 minutes. I want to call upon the volunteers as we are having session one of prayer surgery. The Spirit of God has already come down upon you. He has forgiven you of all your sins. The Bible says, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us of all our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Three of you will get an emergency prayer number. Let's now call upon the volunteers, please. Will you please distribute? Three of you will get one. You will find all the emergency phone numbers that you will call on God in your life hereafter. Shall we just have it distributed, please? And if there is extra, you may give whatever is remaining. Will you please get your... It is entitled Emergency Prayer Numbers. All the specialists are here. Whenever you are in trouble, these emergency numbers may be dialed directly. No operator assistance is needed. Please look at the emergency phone numbers. I hope all of you will get a hold on this. Volunteers, please make sure if there are sheets remaining, try to distribute all the sheets. Try to distribute as many as possible. Keep it safely in your Bible. This will help you. This is a great book. I want to request all our volunteers to kindly distribute all the sheets available. Don't have even one. Please. Good morning. Praise God. I need to tell you as we are continuing this session, why do we have this session? Maybe some of you thought this is going to be a program, this is going to be an event. No. Friends, everybody here needs prayer. Shall we say amen? Amen. Is there anybody here who says, I do not need your prayer? Can we see your hands? Is there anybody? I'm sure you're humble enough to say, I need prayer. We all are in a crisis. I will tell you why I have to arrange this meeting. Because I have already been in many crises, and I know in my life there are some crises I cannot get through it unless I pray. I had a very hard time growing up in my life. We are five children to our parents. My dad was not even an Adventist like most of you. My grandfather used to work in the temple, and he used to be a priest, literally worshiping the idols. One day, Seventh-day Adventists came, conducted prayer, and they conducted 2 weeks evangelistic meeting. For the first time, they heard about Sabbath. My dad was a high-ranking official as a headmaster in one of the government schools. He was paid very handsome salary. But he resigned on the spot and was baptized into the Adventist church. You know, in our mission, we do not pay much. We are five children, and without any exaggeration, if I can be brutally honest with you, I've been a very affected child as I was growing, because in my life I have seen nothing but only poverty. At one point, I even hated my life. All my friends started studying, and I had to stop my studies because I could not pay for my education. My juniors even jumped beyond me. As I was staying home, not going to school, not going to college, while all the other friends started going up, I knelt down and prayed, Lord, if you ever give me some money, I promise to dedicate the whole of my life to become a pastor. And I will serve you for the rest of my life. just give me some money. In India, one of the easiest ways that students can gain money is by selling books. But it's a very tough job because the climate in India, those of you who have been there, is so hot. In India, we have only three climates: hot, hotter, and hottest. Very difficult. And under this very hot, hotter, hotter sun, I used to carry my books and start selling stuff. And I had to really come to a place. Many days, nobody would buy books. Many days, no sales. Many days. One day, my brother and myself were in the hot sun selling books. I still remember we had 10 rupees. Lunchtime, nobody bought. That's the time a new soft drink had come, and we got, my brother was very sacrificial. I just sipped a little bit and I gave it to him. He sipped a little bit and I gave it to me. No food, no nothing, hot sun, no money. My brother was looking at me and I looked at him. I went to the room that day and I told God, "Lord, I'm very tired of my life. I want you to do something in my life that I can get some money and go to school." That's the first time I really started pouring out my heart to God. I want to tell you, my friends, next day I just met one guy. I had so much of money, I could study for the whole of 1 year. Amen? Every year I had to sell books. Every year, just working for 2 or 3 weeks, God. But I will tell you what I did. I used to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning and I knelt down and I prayed and I prayed and I prayed. God told me, go this place, go this place, go this place. Exactly in 1 day, I would sell 20,000, 30,000. We used to have all this Maxwell's children's story. If you sell one set, one whole year you can study. We used to sell 2 sets, 3 sets. Honestly speaking, that's how I studied, graduated. I want to take you through this prayer surgery. I want you to think of your life right now. You don't have to tell your pastor. You don't have to tell any of your friends. What is your crisis right now, my friend? In Jesus' name, come to the program sheet. Come to the last page. I want all of you to come with me to the last page. Do you find something there? Do you find this verse? If you find this verse, will you say yes? Amen? Go to your program sheet. Go to your program sheet. Prayer surgery. Everybody is given a crisis. Whether you're good or bad, you will have financial crisis, emotional crisis, psychological crisis, marital crisis, relational crisis, academic crisis, any crisis. I don't care what crisis. And there are some crises in your life right now that nobody can heal except God. But I want you to come intentionally to this as we are getting into the first prayer session. I want to request all of you, please, unless we have this prayer surgery, unless God does something to your heart, our prayers will not be heard. And so the first prayer we are going to offer, let's read this verse. Sow to yourselves in righteousness, reap in mercy, break up your fallow ground, for it is time to seek the Lord till he come and rain righteousness upon you. When you study this verse, you don't understand anything. We are going to enter into our first prayer session. Welcome to prayer number one. Break up. Unless the Lord breaks you, he cannot build you. Do you have troubles in your life? The Lord wants to break you right now. Do you want to have building up experience? Let's go. The first thing is, you can write it down in the fill in the blank, the preparation. God is preparing you for a surgery. Before a surgery is performed, the very first thing is that they will prepare you. Before the Lord does the surgery, please come here. Break up. Are you broken this afternoon? Is your marriage broken? Is your academic broken? Is your emotional life broken? Praise God. Is your spirituality broken? Sometimes the Lord breaks you down that you will be prepared. Second, this is another beautiful prayer. Break up your fallow ground. If you are experiencing trouble this afternoon, I want you to question yourself and be very honest with God. What is that sin in my life which is a hindrance that God cannot hear my prayer? Let's enter into the first surgery prayer. I want all of you to offer this prayer. Many of us, many of our lives, many of our prayers are not heard because we have not forgiven our enemies. For the next 1 minute, I want you to think of that person who has hurt you the most, who has destroyed your life, who has ruined your reputation, who has damaged your whole life, and you've been holding this grudge. Close your eyes right now. In Jesus' name, forgive that enemy. Choose to forgive that person. Let me pray that prayer silently as you forgive your enemies and pray for yourself. Amen. This prayer surgery does a lot of good. Exactly last general conference, 5 years ago, the Lord invited me to speak at the general conference. We were going to obtain the U.S. visa. I was very excited because for the first time, I was planning to go to the U.S. Just before going, I discovered one of my best friends who ate with me, who slept with me, we were the best and the thickest friends. He wrote to the U.S. Embassy and mentioned my name not to give me a visa. Actually, I was very deeply hurt and very deeply angered. He has been my best friend, for the simple reason he was not going. This letter did so much of damage. 37 delegates who were supposed to go were turned down. He just sent one email. But the good thing about U.S. Embassy is that any email they receive, they will forward it to your mail. If you're interested in my friend's email, I can forward it to you. No? Those of you who are planning to go to GC, okay. I did not forgive him for 2 years. I want to be very honest. 2 years. I would not take revenge, but I had this deep, deep hurt because he destroyed me. 37 people could not make it because he wrote. One day the Holy Spirit spoke to me. If you want me to use you, you must let go and forgive him. I forgave him. But after 3 months, I resurrected and I could not forgive him again. I'm being very honest with you. I forgave him, and after 3 months, again for one more year, 3 years, till 2013. From 2010 to 2013, I did not forgive him. And I'm ashamed, and I'm not ashamed to confess this in front of all of you. But from the day I chose to forgive him, my life has never been the same. Are there any hindrances in your life? Let it be your husband, let it be your wife, let it be anyone who has hurt you. Your boss, your employer, your employee, the prayer surgery will remove that cancer. Remove that fallow. Let's get into this another one. For it is time. Hallelujah. All these presentations will be there in www.prayerpriority.com. Don't even have to worry about this. You can freely download. Beginning tomorrow morning 10, it will be there for 1 week. All the presentations will be present from tomorrow morning until 1 week. So don't worry. It is time. The Lord breaks me and he removes the hindrance. The next is, it is time. It is time not to have PhD. It is time not to excel in your career. It is time not to be married to your sweetheart. It is time. Lord, there is an urgency of prayer. This afternoon we are going to get into an intense prayer. What is that? I want all of you to read that yellow word. Will you please read? Can you please read a little more louder, because we're going to. 1, 2, 3. One more time. You know what is our prayer focus this afternoon? To seek the Lord. I will tell you something in Jesus' name. Whatever problem you've been having for all these months, right after this prayer session, miraculously, God will resolve your crisis. Amen. Amen. You will experience it. And if you have good testimony, write a mail to our prayer ministries. We'll be happy to praise God. To seek the Lord. Let's go over all this. Beautiful. Break up. Fallow ground. It is time, praise God, to seek the Lord. Friends, don't pray right now for your husband, for your wife, for your children, for your education, for your money. No, these are elementary prayers. These are kindergarten prayer. We're going to pray the first session, kneeling down. Let's go here. Till you don't have money to pay your fees, don't leave God until he gives you money. Are you looking for a husband or a wife? Don't leave God until he gives you a wife or a husband. Don't get a husband or a wife without prayer. That is going to be dangerous. Ask God until he talks about the persistence of prayer. What are we going to pray for? We are going to kneel down and pray. Any idea what are we going to pray? Until he comes. Don't say, Lord, bless me, give me money, give me. We have graduated. When I was a child, I speak as a child. I understood as a child. Now all things are gone. You are now beyond your graduate studies. Till Jesus, the dynamic presence of Christ in prayer comes to you. How are we going to pray? What are we going to pray for the next few moments? Let's look at the Bible, please. Will you please read the last four lines? Rain righteousness upon you. Rain righteousness. We are going to pray for the Holy Spirit. Many of us have not asked the rain. We have not had rain for a long time. Praise God. Right now, as we are praying for rain, God is giving us the physical rain. Amen? This is just the early rain. Wait for the latter rain. Let's go here. Beautiful. We're all going to club ourselves into groups of threes. Will you please do that right now? Groups of, find your prayer partner. 3, 3, 3. Please find yourself. 3, 3, 3. 3, 3, 3. This is how we are going to pray. We are going to take 12 minutes for this prayer. Please listen very carefully and follow the instruction. We're going to take 12 minutes. The first prayer will be personal prayer. All of us will kneel down and ask to fill me with the Holy Spirit for 3 minutes. Let's kneel down. Don't ask for anything. Ask God to rain His righteousness. The first prayer is personal, but you will still be in a group of three. First one, pray to God to rain the Holy Spirit on you. Only the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, Amen. The second prayer, I want you to lay your hands on your neighbor, one of the neighbors. You're going to pray for the next person who is kneeling with you. And the other person will pray for the other. So you will have three prayers offered. Each of you will take two minutes. This prayer will be for 6 minutes. Each person, lay your hand and pray for the other person, 2 minutes each, 6 minutes prayer. Praise God. Before I invite Vocal 7 to come and sing for us, Vocal 7, this is a very important prayer. We're going to offer a very special prayer for AUP. As I was listening to the Spirit of God, Lord, where do you want me to conduct? The Holy Spirit impressed very strongly that I should have this prayer in AUP for some reasons unknown. We're all going to stand up right now and pray a special prayer for AUP, that God will fill everyone with the Holy Spirit. We're going to pray for every student. Remember, boy or girl, young or old, graduate, undergraduate, it doesn't matter what discipline, what department, what country, we're going to pray that every student will receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We're also going to pray that every faculty and staff in AUP will receive the anointing of the power from high. Amen. And we're going to very specially pray that every administrator, vice president, those in power, the president, they will receive the power and the anointing of God like never before. And let me tell you, my friends, right after this prayer, I believe that God will transform this place like Jerusalem. Amen. That it will be a modern Jerusalem in the Philippines. Power, disciples, apostles will proceed. Shall we all stand? I want you to pour your heart, plead for AUP. There is power even in one powerful prayer. Imagine all these saints praying. I want all of you to pour your heart like water. Pray that this place will be full and be shaken with the power of the Holy Spirit. 3 minutes. And then after that, I invite Vocal 7 to come forward and give us the special number. Let's pray for 3 minutes. Once you are through with your prayer, you may be seated, please. vocal 7. And after this, we will offer the last prayer of prayer surgery.
I cry, O Lord, I am afraid. I've been walking alone all these days. I deserve the fate, O God, all this time. Hear my cry. Shepherd, He cares for you. The Lord is your keeper. Throw away your fear. If you believe, you don't need to fear. The apple of God's eyes, you will be. So glad, O Lord, for your care. Though the devil tempts me, I shall not fall. Trust in the Lord, the victory is mine. On my knees I cry, O Lord, oh, in me. Savior, Savior, hear my humble cry. While on others thou art called holy, do not always on your side. The Lord is your shepherd. He cares for you. The Lord is your keeper. Throw away your fear. If you believe, you don't need to fear. The will be.
Our last 9 minutes will be heart transplant prayer. This will bring our prayer surgery to an end. When the Holy Spirit impressed on me that we should have special season of fasting and prayer, I walked right into the administration building in AUP. I asked them, how much does it cost to hire this hall? They said it will cost approximately around 7,000 odd. If you've used the AC, this is, if you use the light, you, the PA system, 7,000 and odd. I'm a full-time student, and I'm a sponsored student. I said, Lord, I'm willing to fast and pray, but what about the money? And so I consulted with my organizing team. Is it okay if we collect a little bit of money from people? So I was very excited about collecting money, not for my bank account, but just to pay this electricity and facilities. One of my best family friends happens to be a doctor. I was in the hospital for 2 days. I was sick. One whole month I suffered. So I had to see my throat specialist and an ENT. So he happens to work in Southern Luzon Hospital. It's a very expensive hospital. I went there with a lot of fear. How much would he charge me? I was not very sure. And I casually invited one of the doctors. We are having a special season of prayer. Believe me, I'm going to meet a doctor. The doctor said, we are very happy. Who is paying the expenses for this hall? I said, we are planning to collect some money. And I believe the Holy Spirit spoke through them to me. The Spirit of God told, we will sponsor this whole event and the facilities. Amen. And my organizing team said, we need to get t-shirts. I moved to tears as I share this. Now, God took care of AC, God took care of electricity, God took care of peace system. Will God take care of the t-shirt? So I went all the way. So somebody told me, go to a place called Divisoria. That's where you find the best for the cheapest price. So I went to Divisoria, and the same doctor drove me there. As I was talking to a t-shirt, all of a sudden I heard a lady voice, Pastor Paul, who knows me in Divisoria? Man, I know people know me, and I looked at the woman, I could not really get her face, honestly. And I remember seeing that lady, and after few seconds I know, wow, she attends Pasai Church. Pastor Paul, what brings you here? Actually, we are having a prayer and fasting. My desire is, we want to buy t-shirts, but honestly I do not have much money. Can you help me to bargain the prices with this woman? Man, that's where I saw the force of women's ministries. I don't believe in women's ordination, but I believe in women's coordination. So I spoke to the woman. She said, don't worry, I will talk to them. Pastor Paul, please tell me, how many t-shirts do you need? Actually, I need about 150 to 200 t-shirts. Go home, I will sponsor all 200 t-shirts. I'm going to call them at the end. I've been looking for that couple. Are they here? Not yet. But there are three couples that are involved. I will call at the end. Then something told my heart, we cannot simply ask these people to come. At the end, we have to give some snacks. I want to give them some lime juice. I want to give them some pandesal. I want to give them, not during the fasting, but after the fasting. There was a man seated next to me. He said, I will sponsor the whole snacks. Next, I'm planning to ask God for a helicopter after this. friends, I spent zero on this. But I had a very, very tense moment just before this. The Lord invited me to speak in the United Kingdom in London. They told me, somebody saw me in YouTube and said, come, we are excited to have you 12 days to London. They saw me with a suit and with a tie. They thought this man has a lot of money. They told me, just pay your ticket, we will reimburse. Good invitation, but bad. I went to the Lord in prayer. I did not have the money to go for even visa. I want to be very honest. I have a doctor who also is in Pasa. He told me, I will help you with the ticket. He's right here. I will call him at the end. I went to the visa section. It is called, what building was that? Echo Plaza. Sir, right now you have come at the last moment. If you want to go to UK, you cannot go. But there is something called priority service. What is that priority service? You pay 11,900, you get priority. That's where this word priority was born. What is priority? In 3 days, you will be given priority. How much do I pay? 11,900. 11,900? That's the first time I was going to get a mild cardiac arrest. Where will I go? I was so embarrassed, I didn't have the money. He said, sir, who are you? I'm a pastor. The man just took my application, wet inside. I'm telling this. How much money you have? Said, this is what. Whatever money you have, give it to me. This is in the embassy. I did not have the entire money. Whatever money I had, I gave it. I got my priority visa. Before you say amen, just wait. Now I got my visa. There is no money for ticket now. I talked to one of the members in Pasa. He's a very rich man. He told me it would cost you 67,000. He said, I will help you to book the ticket. I spoke to England, they said, your allotted money is 45,000. I was ashamed to contact him. How can I negotiate for 67 while I prayed. Ultimately, I told them, actually, I'm very, very busy here. Can you book my ticket? But the fact is, I didn't have the money. To cut the story very short, they booked me in the most expensive Singapore Airlines. Now I got my visa. Now I got my ticket. But I do not have even $5 to go to UK. How can you go there and stay there for 2 weeks? Somebody said, I got an email, can you come and preach in Indonesia, in Jakarta? I said, I'll be very happy. They booked my ticket. I'm telling you the truth. I was praying a selfish prayer. Lord, please don't mistake me. I want you to speak to at least one guy. Let them just give me $100 to me, please. I don't want to preach for money. Inspire someone to give me $100 that I will at least take this money and go. But I want to tell you, my friends, God did not answer my prayer. Can you say amen? Amen. Because God did not give me $100. They gave me $1,000. You have to be very careful what you pray for. Let me show this to you. I learned a lesson. Sometimes I hardened my heart against faith. Pharaoh hardened his heart, neither would he let the people go. How many of us need a heart transplant that our faith exists no more? I want you to look here at the next verse. This is amazing. When people saw the land, they discouraged the heart of the children of Israel. How is your heart? God wants to perform a heart transplant prayer right now. I want to read Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give the desires of thine heart. I'm a PhD student. I have to tell you, I'm very ashamed to say this. There was some politics with one of my officers. He did not grant me to get a laptop. My wife also is a full-time student. I'm a full-time student. I came with a very old laptop. I used to do my assignments and I wait. I give it to her. She does it. She will do the assignments. She will give it to me. I'm a full-time PhD student. My wife is a graduate student. I was tired. And after some time, this old laptop, it died. I was very hurt. I've been praying for this laptop for 3 years. 3 years. I went to England. I never asked for anything to anyone. I got some initial amount that I can at least put the down payment. So I had 26,000 to pay down payment. I went, I contacted one friend. I said, sir, I would like to get your help. If you can kindly help me to please get me a laptop. I struck a deal with one of my friends, said, every month I will give you some money. So we put 26,000. I went to Festival Mall in Alabang. I got my laptop, came home. By the time I came home, I saw a message waiting for me. Pastor Paul, when you came here to England, we saw you miserably handling, not having a laptop. God spoke to us, we are sending 16,000 extra. Now I had 26,000. They sent another 16,000. So I went and deposited in my friend's account 16,000. I went home. I saw another message on the Skype. This is from another brother of the church. We are sending you another 10,000. I want to tell you, I wanted to pay different. Yesterday before sunset, somebody had sent me another 14,000. My laptop money is paid in just 1 hour. Amen? Amen? What are you asking for? What are you asking for? Before sunset yesterday, I received 14,000. My laptop, I want to tell you, I specifically asked, Lord, give me a MacBook Pro 13 inches retina display. Don't give me this Dell and Bell, no. MacBook Pro. Our God is a God of quality. Amen? Amen? We're going to ask for a special prayer right now. Delight thyself also in the Lord. He will grant the desires of your heart. What is your desire? Some of you are in need of life partner. We're going to pray right now. Some of you are in need of finance. We're going to pray right now. Some of you want your marriage to be healed. God is going to heal you right now. We have 3 minutes. Let's all stand. Let's all stand. Father in heaven, this is a great sinner standing before you, but I plead the blood of Jesus on me, upon me. You heard all the prayers that I have offered. I want to pray for these people who are standing. Cleanse them with your precious blood. Lord, will you please look deep into their heart? Take away the stony heart. Give them the heart of flesh. Right now, Lord, there are many students who want a sincere life partner in the process of selecting their life partner. I beg you, Lord, give them a life partner, not of their choice, but of your choice. I want to pray for the students who have no money, who are so worried, what will they eat tomorrow? How will they register next month? What will they really go through? They do not have pocket money. God, as they are delighting in you, I beg of you and I pray with all my heart, give them money to pay their fees in Jesus' name. Give them the pocket money. Give them the tuition fee. Heal their heart. Give them the good grade in academics. Help them to deal with the tough teacher. Help them to write their thesis. Help them to do whatever they want. I beg you, Lord, transform our heart in this prayer surgery. Take away the stony heart. Put the heart of flesh. Remove the carnal nature in this prayer surgery. Please perform this amazing and wonderful feat of giving them a new heart, a new spirit, a new desire, a new flesh. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. Our first session is over. We're going to have song service right now. This is the time we are giving you. There is calamansi juice and water. You may kindly go and refresh yourself right here if you want to use the restroom. But make sure you just take 15 minutes. It is not a break. We are entering into second session. This session is called Prayer Graph.